Hey guys, Mtast here, and I wanted to talk about Redrix's Claymore while the topic is hot. I'm on vacation for a few more days, so I apologize for the audio and everything, but I just wanted to talk about this because people were pissed. People are kind of still pissed, but I wanted to discuss the Redrix's Claymore and Redrix's Broadsword a little bit with you guys. So, people were pissed the other day because essentially they said, Claymore can only be gathered by playing competitive this season, that's it. And then, at the end of this season, they said, oh, by the way, there's a clone called the Redrix's Broadsword that can have random rolls, and is essentially the exact same weapon, and you don't have to do the comp grind, you can do a quest line for it. And people were pissed. I've said that like five times, but people were very, very angry because I would argue that the current grind to get Redrix's Claymore is pretty brutal and pretty unfun in a lot of people's eyes. I don't think that competitive is in a good spot right now. And so people that got the gun feel very betrayed that, the fact that they're giving away essentially another version of this weapon for a very different grind. However, they've now shown the quest line, and it is pretty damn in-depth. I'm talking hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of games played, hundreds of kills, pulse rifle headshots, resetting your valor five times, which is in itself hundreds of games played. And it's very interesting. It's very interesting because it is a very tangible way to get the broadsword, which is essentially Redrix's Claymore. I think it's a very fair quest line. It's going to take some major time to do it. Some people are saying that it's too much time to get it. But I mean, come on. If you're giving away a weapon like this, you have to value the people who got the Claymore the original way. And I think that this quest line is very fair. A lot of it is play X amount of games, not win X amount of games. I think that the kill totals are pretty fair, and if PvP is as fun as we think it's going to be, getting five times the Valor reset doesn't seem like that much. I was talking to True Vanguard the other day, I just asked him, I was like, how many times have you reset your Valor? And he said, easily, 10 to 11 times or more, and sometimes he just doesn't reset it, because he just doesn't care. And so, if you are religiously playing PvP all season long, I don't think that these should be an issue whatsoever. And the other thing, too, is you have to remember that it's okay if it takes you a while to get this gun. It took people all season to get Redrix's Claymore. This is a very similar thing. Broadsword should not be something you should be banging out in a week or two. And if you are, you're probably playing 20 hours a day, right? It's going to be a good weapon. Maybe not the best weapon. The random rolls might make it awesome. But you have to remember there's going to be other amazing guns out there. And if you don't get Broadsword right away, I wouldn't freak out about it. It might not even be the best. It might be a good option, but it might not be the best. Even right now, Redrix's Claymore is like a 5 out of 10. There are moments where it's a beast and it shines, but overall as a weapon, it's not that great. We don't know what the damage numbers are going to be on it going into the next season. We don't know if it's going to be a 2-shot kill or a 3-shot kill or whatever it might be. And so freaking out about it right now is kind of useless. But I honestly think that this quest line to get the broadsword is a much, much better experience overall than grinding for the Claymore right now. If you're close, you might want to get the Claymore right now because it might be a little bit easier and you might get it a lot sooner than trying to do the broadsword quest line when Forsaken launches. I mean, there's no denying, it's going to take days and days and days of getting this weapon. So if you're halfway there, you have some time to kill before Forsaken launches, try and get that Claymore. You might just do it. I don't know. I think that it's very fair. A lot of people are so angry saying, this is bullshit, right? I earned this weapon and now they're giving it away? Well, some people might argue that it's just as hard, if not harder, to get this weapon. More time-consuming. I know people that got the Redrix's Claymore in the first week because they played and won pretty much every game they played. Those are top-tier guys, obviously, but it's possible. With this one, even if you're the best player around, you're not going to get this weapon very quickly. So, I think it's fair. I think it's a very, very fair thing. That's my thoughts on it. I don't know what you guys think on it, but I'm very excited to do the quest line. Personally, I don't think that I'm going to be grinding competitive to get this weapon before Forsaken launches, because I just don't really have time. I don't have the drive. I don't like the state that the competitive playlist is in right this second. But with changes like the addition of radar and changes to the time to kill and weapon system, it might be a badass experience going forward. And if that's the case, sweet. Throw some more rewards at me. I'll grind them out later. But for right now, I'm personally looking towards the broadsword more than anything else. I don't know why I made this video. I guess I just wanted to talk to you. I miss you, bastards. I miss you so much. Anyways, that's it from me. I'm shaking my camera. Hopefully you enjoyed, and I'll see you soon, my friends. Bye-bye.